guys, good to have you all back. We are celebrating. Yes, have you seen it? I have reached 20,000 subscribers. What? Yes, I know. I have no words. The only words I have is thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you guys so much. I mean, honestly, it sounds a little bit cheesy, but it really is true. I could not have done this without you. I cannot subscribe 20,000 times to my own channel. I do have friends and relatives. All 5 of them subscribed. So yes, the rest is all you. So thank you so, so much. So we're celebrating. I've made a new digital kit and of course a freebie for you guys. And also I'm going to do a lovely little project with the digital kit, of course. So let me first show you the digital kit and freebie, and then let's make something for the digital kit. Now, a while ago, I bought these bills and notes and checks and what have you from an antiques dealer. These were a little bit expensive, but I love them so much. They're all from 1888, some of them from 1889. I'm sorry, I need to translate and also never use that date because I wasn't born then. They're beautiful. They're really, really in good condition. Sometimes I find these and someone with a red marker puts like an X on it or a number on it, and I don't really like it. They were all from Schiedam. Schiedam is a small sort of town, a suburb of Rotterdam. I cannot call it that because you know, all people from Schiedam are going to be upset with me. But it's sort of a part of Rotterdam, yes? And most of this was from the same gentleman. He's called Melchers. Yeah, and they're all different. I love them. Look at this, yes. So what did I do? Yes, you guessed it. I scanned them. Not all of them, because some of them were not that good to scan because of the color or, you know. But I scanned most of it and I made this beautiful kit. So let me show you. The kit is a two-parter. Let me show you part one. I have these wonderful sort of bank checks, bank receipts. Beautiful. For 75 cents in 1888. I especially love this, of course. Yes. Just love it. Now, I'm going to do a small project using these, yeah, today. Now, then I have these two sort of small receipts. This is actually from a butcher. Can you... Oh, I just love the fonts on this. And then the cow and the sheep. And love it. And then this is actually from a patisserie. It's like a place where they sell desserts and chocolates and bonbons and all sorts of lovely stuff. So... fantastic. Now, guys, on the bottom, you might notice if you have more of my kits, these have been in one of my kits before. But there was a blank space here and I really wanted to fill it with something. And I just personally love using these labels. So I just put them on again. Why not? And this is a very small sort of, well, the envelope itself is big, but I made it really small so that you can make this into a label as well. Just thought it was really cute. Now, this one. This was actually a really big piece. It was a fold-out. It was really, really large. It is from an apothecary. Again, 1888 from Schiedam. Oh, love this. Yes, lovely, beautiful handwriting. Sort of ledger type of paper. This is from a Roman Catholic church for 1 guilder. And this is a subscription for 3 months for a newspaper. Actually, a little bit expensive. 3 months newspaper. 3 guilders and 45 cents. That is expensive, but you know. And then, yes, 2 more labels that I've already used in another kit. But I just love these. Now, the last one for this part of the kit are 4 of these receipts or notes or bills or what you want to call it. Yes, this is a furniture upholstery company. Yeah, so cool with the seal on it. I don't know which company this is, but I just love the font and such. And there's another sort of a receipt. And this one, this actually made me giggle because I read it really, really fast. And I was like, snobble. It's actually snabel because there's only one B. But the snobble, freely translated, is something like side hustle. So it's like... my company is named Side Hustle. So that was very funny to me. Now guys, for the second part of the kit, let me show you the inspiration. Months ago, and I mean months ago, I received this in Happy Mail from a very good friend of mine. And I was, oh, you've probably seen it. I've probably shown it in a video somewhere. Yes, this is these are antique French fashion magazines from 1878. So about the same date as the receipts were. Yes, all about fashion. Love them. Love them. So I have finally gotten around to scanning them because, oh my gosh, look at those. Look at those. And I have two books and there's so much in here. So look at this. Oh, I couldn't scan this, guys. There was two pages and I tried to sort of fix them together. And I'm sorry, I couldn't. But I scanned a lot. I scanned a lot. And then, now, keep this in mind. I am not a digital artist by no means. But I did some sort of altering and editing. And I don't know what it's called. But I came up with this. Yes, these are actually almost the same receipts as these, but then with the lovely ladies on them. Aren't these gorgeous? I love them so much. Oh, it's so beautiful. I am so proud for me that I have accomplished this. Yes, I have more ideas, guys, but you know, one step at a time. I just love them. Yes, journal cards. You can decorate a little bit more, put writing on the back. Oh, and then the bigger ones. The one from the butcher and the patisserie with more ladies on them, of course. Aren't these beautiful? Oh, love them so much. Now, for these postcards, I have used a couple of these in a previous kit, but they were blank. And now I decorated them with scarves and collars. And all sorts of loveliness, and enough room to do some more decorating or some writing or what have you. Just love them. Look at this. Yeah, these actually also came from the magazines. These were smaller pieces that I sort of blown up and then put bags in them. These are bags. Yeah, aren't these wonderful? Love them. So I made my sort of my own advertisement piece. Another one of these receipts with the lovely ladies on them. Oh, and a small bits and bobs here. There. Now, that's it for the kit. For the freebie. The freebie, guys. Let me show you. 3-page freebie. Yes, I scanned one of the covers of the magazine because they are gorgeous. And you can make small bits and bobs out of these because there's a number 17 here or a date here. You could make this into something, do some fuzzy cutting of the lady, just use this. You could use all sorts, these ladies in the back, or just use as a whole. So fantastic. Then I have these. There's two page. Another one of these lovely sort of covers. Look at the ladies. Oh. And then all the hats. I had to include this, guys. You can just fussy cut all of them. Use them individually or, you know, do whatever. And then those four of them. I just adore these. Yeah. And I hope you do too. Yeah, make them into journal cards, decorate them a little bit more, again, fussy cut them, do whatever you want, lovies. They're just fantastic in any sort of project, yeah. So, yeah, that's a 3-page freebie as well. I have a little note about the freebies because there are still some questions. Let me sort of explain. If you want to download these on Ko-fi, there's sort of a screen that says put your amount here. Yes, so that is, there's a little bit of confusion. Do I put in an amount? You can put in zero because it's free and you can get this for free. Now, I know there are a couple of ladies out there that really want to support my channel. And I love you guys for it. Really, I love it. So some of you put another amount in there. And that's fantastic. That just keeps my channel going. But I have a little side note on this, because some of the ladies put in an amount like 25 cents or 50 cents. And thank you so much, because that's probably an amount for you that you can spare. But I'd rather you keep it in your pocket. Why? Let me tell you. Everything below $1, a part goes to Ko-fi because they do charge, and the other part goes to PayPal because they do charge, and then the last part goes to our tax offices because, you know, they charge a lot. So basically I will receive nothing of your 25 or your 50 cents. I am totally okay with this, guys, because I've offered this as a freebie, but I do not want to see your money go to waste to bigger companies or governments or what have you, with the idea that you wanted to support me. So please, lovies, if you're going to do something below $1, keep it in your pockets. Thank you so much for the idea, but just I want you to keep it. Everything like $1, perfect. That's perfect. But below $1, please keep it in your pocket because it makes me feel bad. It makes me feel bad. Not that I don't receive the money, but that you think that I will receive the money. Hopefully I'm making sense, and don't be offended. I just looking out for you guys. So yeah, that's the story for the freebie and why Ko-fi says zero. Just put in zero. It's for free. Okay, guys, let's start making some lovely stuff with the first one. Where was it? Somewhere, nowhere to be found. This one. Yes, go print out the kit if you want to have a play along. Yeah, we're gonna start with these. Well, I did a little fuzzy cutting. Yes, yeah, so I cut everything out. Now, guys, I did some pages. I printed two to a page. Yes, for instance, like this one and a couple of them, probably this one and such, because I wanted them to be smaller than they are now. Yeah. So just, you know, select two the pages that you want to print, and then the left mouse button or right mouse button, I don't know, the mouse button, and then you click print, and then there's the option two page. I am so sorry, I am not an IT girl, but you can print them two page. That'll make them look smaller, like these. See, these were actually way bigger. Unless you print them two page. Okay, I am not using anything outside of the ordinary than just glue, scissors, a little bit of inking. I am going to sort of make a booklet with this that I'm going to bind in. So I am using my book binding kit, which is an awl, a big needle, and this is wax thread. You can use any sort of thread that you want, lovies. I'm still thinking about the closure. I'm either going to use an eyelet with some baker's twine or some other twine or something completely different, but no clue yet. Okay, but let's start with these. Now, I did not print anything double-sided. You can, guys, because we're gonna fold it in and then the white is going to be visible. But what I want to do is sort of make a lovely collage on the inside using my small bits and bobs. Yes, so let's start making a collage on these insides. There's going to be a booklet inside. Now, I have already picked out some pages that I want to use. I'm going to use the cards, and I'm going to use these lovely ladies from the freebie. They're not really the exact same size, but I'm going to sort of glue them together and trim them, and these are then going to be the pages inside. It's just going to be a small little booklet. So I'm using this to sort of collage with. Yes, I need a glue page. There we go. Well, some relaxing collaging. Guys, let's have a chit chat. Oh yes, I am still, my husband Tim and I, we were talking about it yesterday. About the 20,000 subscribers. He's really, really supportive, guys. He's always checking what's going on my channel and congratulating me, and you know. So we were sort of waiting for it to hit 20,000 subscribers yesterday in the kitchen while making dinner. Oh, I love him so much. That man gets so excited. It was such a nice sort of event for us. We did have sort of a celebration. Yeah, we did. I just want some of these numbers. Yeah, let's just have a piece here. So yeah, but as he mentioned, he's like, how is this happening, love? What is going on? And honestly, we don't know. We don't know. This is not something that we anticipated at all. I'm not saying I started my YouTube channel as a joke, but just, you know, I was doing Instagram and I really liked it, and I was watching a lot of YouTube videos myself and in awe of all the ladies doing all the beautiful projects, and I was like, maybe I can do this, maybe, let's just see. So I started it about 16 months ago, so not even 1.5 years ago. And so that with the intention, let's just see what's going to happen, and of course have a lot of fun, because that was the most important thing to me, just have a lot of fun. And I still am having a lot of fun. This is too long, but I'm going to trim it. Loads of fun with you guys. Made so many friends. Yeah, and well, it's my job now. Sort of a full-time job now. There you go. What we're gonna have here? I have some of these. Oh yes, these. And then a strip of something there. Sure. Let's have Mr. Side Hustle on. Oh, it was so funny. Yes, and then we need a strippy of something. Strippy of this? No, strippy of this. Yeah. So yeah, I've been playing with my scanner and some other programs to sort of make the images a little bit more transparent, so you can put them on here. But that takes a long time, and I'm teaching myself. I try to you know, watch some videos with some courses and such, and I always get sort of confused. Like, wait, what did you say? What's going on? I don't know what you're talking about. So yeah, most of the times I'm just like, gonna figure it out myself. That's a perfect fit. That is a perfect fit. Are we making two? Well, we're making two, so that means this is going to be a long video. There you go. Whoops. Oh, look at the suitcases. I just love them. Let me know in the comments, guys, if you like this style, because I personally love this style, and I have way more of this, and I want to use way more, of course. So if you like, let's just put a bigger piece on. Are we? No. So if you want me to make more of these kits, just let me know, because I have loads to share. And it will make me happy because, let me tell you why. Because I want to use them myself. There's a little bit of white here. I did not cut this enough. And I'm also not inking, so. Yeah, I'm not using the originals. So if you want me to scan stuff, I can use it myself. So yes, I am doing this for me, mostly for me. Oh yes, let's put this on because it's lovely. Maybe something underneath? No. Again, you left a little bit of white on here, love. That's oh quite all right if you're going to do some inking, but I am not, so I need to remove it. Some of this and then something here. Yes. Probably yes. The other side around and then I don't know. Don't know yet. You also have some labels, love. Remember the labels? I do remember the labels. But I also remember this. Yeah. What I also found was a lot of children's clothing and such. But I think I want to make a separate kit with just, you know, children's clothing. I'm covering up this bit. Well, you know, that's what happens. Yep. I'm just trimming it. Yes, love it. A little bit of white here, but I'm going to do some inking. Guys, I'm going to let this dry. Let it flatten out, both of them. Yes, and then ink all around it. Isn't it lovely? Oh, I love this part even better than this part. I'll be right back. Now, while my big papers are drying, I want to make the pages. Yes, you can put anything in here, lovies. Just anything. I'm just going to put these in. And I'm going to pair them with something on the back. So I'm just going to sort of glue these together. And some of it will be smaller, some will be taller. But I'm just going to trim them. Just going to trim it. So I'm not going to do anything fancy-smancy. Are you? No. Probably not. I still get some requests of people that say, please make this into a background in one of your projects. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah, it just confuses me. I know I am weird. I am weird, guys. I'm totally weird, but I don't enjoy it myself. And, you know, don't ever do anything that you don't enjoy. How are we gonna do this? Sort of like so. This is glue stick, so we can maneuver it about a little bit. They're not going to be the exact same size, but that's okay. I'm just going to trim them a little bit later. So I'm just basically gluing stuff together. Let's see. Yes, I'm also doing some decorating and some inking and such. And my cat has been on my desk because there are cat hairs now everywhere. Trying to sort of center it so that I will not lose a lot of the lovely designs on the other side. That is way too sticky now. Don't put these two together. Put these together, yeah. The quicker solution would be, you know, print something lovely on the back. That'll be a quick solution. Yeah, I am not into quick solutions today. No. Because now I also need to let these dry because I'm using glue stick. See, it's warping already. But that's okay. Oh, this one's actually bigger than the one below. Okay, well, that's new. That is new. Perfect. Now, I need to let all of these dry and flatten under a pile of books as well. Okay. Guess what happened? I'm going to give you one guess. Yes. Is your guess slow motion button? Yes, it was. I, honestly, I don't know why this keeps happening to me. I'm gonna show you what I did, guys. Yes, first, let me show you the signatures that I made. I made signatures. What did I do? I just folded these in. I folded these in half, inked all around them. Yes, and I added two more papers. Now, this paper, very old brittle paper, was actually the first page of this book, because they were bound in, and then you have sort of a protecting cover on the, not the first page. It has a name, don't know what it's called in English. Schutblad, I don't know. And then also I've used a piece of ledger. Now the ledger is written on one side and then blank on the other side. It was too long, so I made sort of a flap out slash pocket thingy, yeah? And then I made signatures. This is going to go in here. This is going to go in here, and then this is going to go in here. Or I want to have this on the inside, actually. There you go. Yes, so I made two small signatures. Cute, right? Yeah. Oh, love it. Love it so much. Then, let me do this again. Yes, I'm going to show you. Okay, inked everything. Let's pretend you don't see the inking. Let's pretend, yes? I wanted to have this as sort of the flap closure. See? Like so. So I just put it on my scoreboard. You don't need a scoreboard, guys. You can just fold it and just eyeball it where you want it. Yeah. So I just folded it here. Yeah. And then I put this underneath almost all the way to the edge and then fold it here. So this is going to be sort of an overlapping fold. And the signature will fit inside here. Yes. It even leaves a little bit of room. So that's what I did in slow motion. Oh. It needs to have a beep or anything when you accidentally press slow motion. It's next to video button. So, yeah. So this is going to go in here. Again, I just use this as sort of a measuring guide for the flap. Right? And then I inked all around it. Everywhere. Did I mention something really cute? I don't know. Probably I was going on and on about how happy I am with the growth of my channel. Yeah. Okay. Now, what are we going to do now? Before I will sew in the signatures, yes, I want to do some decorating, and especially here on the back. So I think I want to have a small pocket here and here as well. So I'm going to make small pockets and do something over here and maybe even something here or there. Yeah. So let's do some small decorating. Going to make small pockets on the back. Yes, and these are a perfect size. So going to ink all around them first. This is actually from printed on copy paper. I would rather have this on sort of more sturdier paper for a pocket. But for now, it's copy paper. Yeah. But if you're going to do this, guys, have this in sturdier paper, like 160 grams. While I'm inking, I remember what I was talking about. In slow motion, of course. Yeah, I was speaking about that I already did this project in last year's 100 day project. Yes, it was in the beginning somewhere, I don't even know, or halfway through, I don't even know, a little bit in the beginning. Yes, don't go watch it. No, it was a completely different setup. I was very nervous, way more nervous than I am now. I probably had 200 subscribers by then instead of 20,000, which is still ridiculous. I can remember I was really happy when I had 100 subscribers, and then things started rolling. And I was thinking maybe, perhaps, if I'm very lucky, I can have 1,000 subscribers within a year. Because that's the thing, you know, if you do YouTube and you want to have this as a sort of a job or business, you need 1,000 subscribers and lots of viewing hours, lots of viewing hours. Guys, I'm going to glue this on. Yes, just on three sides. I am using art glitter glue for this. Yeah, so I was hoping to have 1,000 subscribers. You probably heard me mention this before. Yeah, and then that happened within four or five months. Ridiculous, ridiculous. And it's still not stopping. So who knows where we'll end? Who knows? artist confused. Am I dripping? Am I snotty? Am I blowing bubbles? I don't know. He's doing everything. I am covering up some lovely bits, but let's just pretend we didn't see this. See? Oh, love it, love it, love it. Boom, boom. Still, he's not finished. I'm trying to finish this bottle so that I can start my new one. I also have a refiller, but I really want to use a new bottle. It's been over 1 year that I'm using this bottle. Yeah? Cute? Very, very cute. Okay, now I also have all of these small bits and bobs. Do we want to have a small label on the front here? Yeah? We will. We will. I also have one of these ladies left. Do we want to fussy cut her? Yes, we want to. I'm going to try to sort of fussy cut her. Because of pretty. She's so pretty. Oh, guys, I scanned so many images. And I'm only halfway through the first edition. Yeah. Oh, yeah. But then I'm going to do it completely different. Yeah. We'll have this behind her. Like so. Something simple but cute. Yes. Actually needs one more thing. But a thing that is not in the kit. So I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to reach outside of the kit. I just want to add another sort of blue, a small blue element here. And there we go. Yes, here's one. Yes, printing two to a page is really nice, guys. I can tell you this because it makes your digital kit completely new because you see different things then. Let's see. What was it that you want? I want some of my sticky sticker labels in, of course, blue. Just one pretty blue one. Lost my big pin. Ooh. Well, it wasn't in its normal spot. Lovely. What are we going to put here? Do we have another lady left? Or we have this cravat. Cravat. Oh no, I have another lady. Oh yes. It's just the back of the lid. It's so gorgeous. I'm not doing a precise fussy cut. I'm just gonna sort of go around the perimeter. Yeah. This? Yes. Are you not doing any stamping today? I don't think so. I don't think I'm going to do any stamping. What? Are you feeling well? No stamping today. It's like she's looking straight into the label. Yeah, nothing to see there, love, but you know. Yep. Yep. Yes, and then another blue label. A couple of colors of blue. Bigger one? No. Not a bigger one. Where's my pin? Here. There we go. Yeah, let's put it here. Fantastic. I have more labels, so I'm gonna put one here and one here. Because why not? Just in the corner. And if you want to stamp, you can stamp something. Yeah, a lovely number. Oops. Yes. Do you want any decorating on the inside? Don't think so. Oh, maybe here. Yes, this one here. For sure. I went a little bit overboard with the inking, but that's okay. You could also have a pocket here on the inside. Yeah, I think I did this with the other project. Ooh, on this one? No. No, I'm going for the label. See, that's why I put in labels, guys. Yeah. You may already have these because you have... I think these were in the pack Ephemera Blue. Because they are blue and it's Ephemera. So probably from Ephemera Blue. Doesn't mean... They can be in here. Fantastic, right? We love it. Okay, we need to make closures. I'm going to do two different sorts of closures. Before we do a closure, let's, you know, put the signature in. Yeah, I took out my wax thread. Yes, I am not going to, because this is a little bit stiff. I think I'm just going to put this sort of twine. Yeah. If you have not never seen me do this before, I'm going to do it a little bit quicker than I would normally do. Have this 2.5 the width of your page. I'm going to do 3 because why not? Yes, I need to do this 2 times. So yes, what you basically need is a big needle. Yes, if you have a bookbinding kit, you probably have this and a bone folder. That's what I bought years ago. A good investment, by the way, guys. Now, be sure all the pages are the right side up. I did decide to put this in the middle because pretty picture, yeah. And have it flush against the center. Everything is in. Yeah, I need a big paper clip or some of these clips to hold them in place. Binding in signature sounds scary. It is actually not, guys. It's okay. Now I'm going to take my awl or pokey tool, but you could also use a big needle. Yeah, don't have this flat on your surface. Have it at an angle. Yeah, I'm just gonna make one hole in the middle. Be sure it lands in the middle. Yes, and then one a little bit on the top, and then the same amount on the bottom. So they're going to be 3 holes. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. Okay, taking out a big needle or a bigger needle. That's a very big one, and a needle threader, because yes, that works much faster than me trying to put this through the needle hole. Eye of the needle. It's not needle hole, it's eye of the needle. Yes. Oh, this is way too small of a hole for this thread. So I actually do need a big needle. Well, that's okay. eye of the needle. Yes, it's a thing. Do we also call it eye? I don't know. Okay, guys, you can go from the inside or from the outside. If you start from the inside, your threads will be on the inside. If you start from the outside, your loose thread will be from the outside. I'm going to go inside. Yeah, always start in the middle. If you're going to do a three stitch pamphlet, I don't know what it's called, three stitch something. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna put it through. Yes, leaving a little bit. Yeah, then go back in the top or bottom, you choose one, guys, choose one. Well, actually, this needle is a little bit too big for the signature that I made, but that's okay. And then do not go back in the middle, go either all the way to the top or the bottom, depending on the way you started. Yeah, okay, still keep it tight, and then you go back in here in the middle. Hopefully there's a little bit of room left. Why are you using the big needle? Because, well, you're not gonna use the embroidery, the wax-free wax floss. Yeah, very smart idea. I'm going to do this one with with the wax floss. You have one thread on this side, one thread on the other side. Make it tight and then tie a double knot. Yes, unclip it. Bob's your uncle. You made a signature. Yeah, so I'm gonna do the same with the other one, but then I'm gonna use this. Now, finally, the closures. I'm gonna do two different ones. Yes, I'm going to start with sort of a, well, a classic one, which means I'm going to put an eyelet here. Yeah, so I'm going to make a hole. Like so, yes. Picked out one of these big ones from We Are Memory Keepers because I really love the color on this bit. Yes, and they are like butter, guys. Yes, they just, you know, you don't even have to squeeze hard. They're really good. They're a little bit more expensive, but they're really good. I really like them. Okay, now for this closure, I'm just gonna use this twine. I'm doubling it up a little bit, yeah, a tiny bit, putting it through. Hello. Yeah. And then without measuring, I'm just gonna put the whole thing through, like so. It was that smart? Probably not. Probably not. Yes. What did you do? We don't know. We don't know, but it's true. Then I'm gonna wind it two times. Just cut it off before you put it through, lovies. Yeah, don't do as I do. Do as I say, not do as I do. Okay. Ta-da, closure. Yeah. Now for the other one. Let me show you. This is something that I found the other day on one of my treasure hunts, my thrift shops. I have not posted that video yet. I have a lovely thrift haul video coming up, probably this Sunday, where I found a couple of these. Isn't she lovely? It's a cameo or a camei or what you want to call it. It's from resin, yeah? It's not anything special. It's not really old or something. But I was thinking to have it on here. Yes, like so. And then with one of the Velcro dots. So what I want to do is see. I'm going to put one of the Velcro dots all the way to this edge. As close to this edge as possible. Yeah, that was the wrong side. Wrong side, love. Yeah, because it's going to go on like so. So you need it on the other edge. Okay, other edge. Fortunately, these are really, really sticky. So that'll work. Now, I have sort of a measurement where I can glue it on. See? For gluing on, I am not trusting any other glue than hot glue. So I'm using a drippy for this. I also need the back of this. Yep. We need to glue it on this side. Yes. Like so. Okay. Well, drippy. There we go. A little bit more, love. Oh, it needs a new glue cartridge. Do we have enough glue on? I think so. I think so. A little bit in the middle. And there we go. See, this is still sticking out. That was important. Alright, so. Oh, lovely. Now we need the other part, the clear part. I always use the clear part on the surface where it's stuck, where it's going to stick to, because that's the thing that's going to be most visible. And because it is clear, it's nearly invisible. Yes. Closing it up, pulling it, pushing it tight. Yes, you can buy these at craft shops, guys, or Amazon, or sometimes if you're very lucky. I'm slowly sort of trying to open it. Yeah, see, closure. Or you can do magnets, but I don't use those. Fantastic. Yes. Oh, love that one, guys. I think this is it. Let's look at the end result. Before I show you the end result, I'm going to do this closure one more time, because that was rubbish. That was absolute rubbish. Just sort of measure it, wrap it around twice and then cut it off. That's much better than what I did. I'm just going to sort of overlap this. See? Have a little bit stick out. Then pull it through. Hopefully it will go in one go. Yes. Yeah. So you have a loop here. And then both of these threads here. Yeah. You pull through. See, that looks way nicer. Yeah, and then hold on to the small one and just wrap the other bigger one around twice. And then you either tie a knot or a bow. Whatever you want, lovies, whatever you want. See, ta-da, way nicer, way nicer. Okay, for the inside. For the inside, let's start with this one. I love her. Isn't she cute? Yes, I found 12 of them. 12, yes. So I need to go use them. Yes, and share them with some friends of mine. I love this one because it's from the same era. And also sort of it goes really nice with this sort of black grayish item here. So when you open it up, like so. Yes. Big label here. Then you have the small signature. I did put in some other bits and bobs. Yes, I did this. It's actually a pocket. You could put something in if you want to. Yeah, you can write on here. Do that more decorating. This is a flap out. You can also make it into a pocket. Put a little piece here. Oh, look at look. Oh, so cute, right? Yeah. And then this. Some more journaling. Put a small label there. It's just all sorts of loveliness. Yes, and on the back we have another small pocket, so you can put something in. Yeah, maybe, you know, one of the cards, for instance. And then the other one that has a lovely closure now. Yeah, lover on the front. Yeah, when you open her up, there's another label here on the inside. Love it. Yeah, I put a sticker label here. And this one wraps all around. Yeah. So there's a piece of label here and piece of label there. Another small label here. It can be a flip out or a small pocket. Put this piece on here. It was just a smaller piece. Yeah. Just all sorts of loveliness. And then on the back, another pocket. So, you know, put something in. Ta-da. Small wallets. Small wallets, guys. Yeah. I forgot to mention, this was not my idea. I have seen this on Rachel's channel, Roxy Creations, and she has seen it from Carol Laws, which is an amazing lady. I love Carol. So the original idea probably came from Carol, and I have not changed a thing about it because it's a fantastic idea. Love these. Now guys, before I let you go, let me show you the kit one more time and tell you where to get it, because it's on Ko-fi, on my Ko-fi website. It is linked below in the description box. Yes, you just, you know, open it up, it is linked below, click on it and it will bring you straight to the kit and the freebie. Also guys, if you have not been subscribed that long and you're watching my older videos where it says freebie available, you can email me. You can email me, but I will direct you to Ko-fi. So all the freebies that I still have available, almost all of them are on Ko-fi. So if you are there, just browse and, you know, take everything you need. Take everything you need. Okay, let me show you. This is part one of the kit. The kit is going to be called 1888 Ephemera. Yeah, because almost everything is from 1888 and it's ephemera. Love these. Yeah. Then we have these two big ones with all the small labels. Again, guys, print two to a page. Try to figure out how this works. I do have a video somewhere where I mention and show you how it works. But I honestly, I don't know which one it was anymore. You can Google it. Yeah. The project that we made, you can also do with this larger piece. It will be a little bit taller then, but it will also be very lovely. Then the four receipts. Very neutral, guys. Put flowers on them, botanicals, flower fairies, frogs, bugs, airplanes, whatever you want. These are very neutral. You can use them for sort of any background that you want. Yes, back them with some writing paper, coffee dyed paper, and voila, you have a journal card. Now, part two of the kit where I added the lovely ladies from 1878. Yes, it's just beautiful. I just love it. And then the postcards. I love this. I just want this. I want to use this. And lovely scarves. I do wear a lot of scarves myself. Scarves, not scarves. Scarves. Yes, but nothing as fancy as this, of course. Oh, I love it. See, just that it has a coveling and then, oh, so pretty, so pretty. We don't dress like this anymore. Well, fortunately we don't, because it wasn't too comfortable, I guess. Oh, and then the advertisement pieces that I made. I made my own advertisement pieces. Just love them. So cool, right? Yeah. And then the freebie. Freebie also available, of course. I think these are the most beautiful pages. So, yeah. Use this. Fussy cut. You can make so many projects with these. Or cut them out, put them in a frame, yeah, and on your wall, because they're beautiful drawings. Yes. And then this one, again, print them two page, four page, you'll make them smaller and smaller and smaller. And this is all when you have a window system, guys. If you have a Mac system, I don't know how that works. No, I don't know how Mac works. Guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it, yeah? I'll be back again tomorrow with another video. I have no clue what we're doing. Again, thank you so much for subscribing. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe, because before you know it, we'll reach 25,000 subscribers. Who knows? Until tomorrow. Bye, guys.